So let's try to think about a method that might perform better for matrices with varying numbers of non-zero elements per row. If you'll recall, the approach that we pursued in Unit 4 was to assign a thread to each element, do one multiplication per element, then use a backwards inclusive segmented sum scan to add up the partial products and generate a result per row. Let's look at this approach step by step so that we can understand it. So we're going to start with a CSR representation of the matrix. So step one, we're going to use the row pointer data structure to generate an array with ones for segment heads and zeros for non-segment heads. Then we're going to launch a thread for each element in the matrix. We're going to multiply it by the corresponding vector element, which we fetch using the index data structure. For thread n, that code will look like value of n times x of index of n. Then we're going to perform our backwards inclusive segmented sum scan, which will sum up all the partial products in the matrix row. And then finally, the output of that sum scan will be a sparse vector, which we might want to pack back into a dense vector. And we can use the row pointer addresses to gather that sparse vector back into the dense vector. Now, let's go answer the same question we asked about the thread per row approach.